Hi, my name is Jimmy Palatsoukas. I'm a senior product manager at Genetec. We're here at this year's ASIS 2012 show in Philadelphia. Once again, Genetec has a slew of new functionalities and features that we're demonstrating at this show. We've got Security Center 5.1, which seamlessly unifies access control, video, and license plate recognition into one security and safety platform. At this year's show, we're also releasing or announcing the release of the SV16 version 2, or the next generation SV16. It supports 16 cameras or 16 readers, or a combination of 8 cameras and 8 readers in this network appliance that ships from Genetec preloaded with our software. Here at the show, we've also got Mobile 3.1, and with Mobile 3.1, we're able to stream video from a smartphone directly into our Security Center software for viewing and archiving. What this means is that any smartphone can be used as a mobile camera in the field. Lastly, we've also got IP intercom integration. We're showing a couple of IP intercom panels. We're integrating with these panels over SIP. The benefit there is that video, access control, and intercom is all blended into one easy to use interface. And now I'll pass it on to Chris Yigit, our product manager for AutoView, and he'll take you through a run through of license plate recognition.
Hi, my name is Chris Yigit. I'm the product manager for AutoView. That's Genetec's license plate recognition solution. Today we're demoing the AutoView Patroller. That's our in-vehicle LPR solution. And over here you can see this is our latest UI. We've recently redone it for our 5.1 release. It's very touch friendly. So across the top you have some pass reads that go here. Everything is very focused around being touch friendly. Zooming in, you can move images around, that sort of stuff. So we're going to start by doing some parking enforcement. So I'm going to start the reading. Every time you hear a beep, that means we read a vehicle. Some of the features that you could see at the bottom. So this tells you how many hits are pending. So whether it's parking hits or hot list hits, it kind of tells you how many hits are waiting to be acknowledged. This particular system does overtime parking. In the overtime parking, what we do is we have to select what type of overtime parking that we're enforcing. For the sake of this demo, we've chosen a 1 minute overtime zone, which is not really realistic, but for the purposes of a demo, gives you a good idea of how the system works. We also have permit enforcement, so you can choose to load a specific permit, be it for an RPP or residential parking permit, or a parking lot. If you're at a university or a college or maybe a large medical institution or even a shopping center, that's where you would use typical permit type enforcement. Okay, so the system triggered alarm letting us know that there's been an overtime hit. What that means is a vehicle has been determined to have the same plate, the same GPS location, and has surpassed the pre-allotted time for the time limit parking. So to enforce this, we can confirm it's the same vehicle, but we're going to take it one step further and we're going to look at the digital tire chalking. So I press the digital tire chalking button, and this is going to give me images of the wheels both before and after. So if I take a look at this one here, for example, I got a good image of the rear tire of this vehicle. I will double click it. It will open up the tire. I can zoom in and I can get a good look at the tire and take a look at, for example, where the valve stem is. And we seem to see something right there. I'm going to now close this, move to the second tire image. We have the rear image right here. So here we can confirm now that it is in fact the same tire. It hasn't moved at all. And we can confirm the hit. So at this point, the officer can choose to accept the hit. And now he determines whether or not he wants to enforce it or not enforce it. If he enforces it, he writes the infraction. If he chooses do not enforce, he has to choose which a reason why, and these reasons are pre-configurable. So you could say city vehicle, police vehicle, emergency vehicle. So we'll just say enforce. And at this point, you can actually automate to a third party where we would automate the printing of the ticket, or you can choose to write it manually and move on to the next infraction.